Welcome back to Patty's Kitchen. I'm really excited to be back doing the market menu. Today, what I'm going to show you is how to make a beautiful barbecued eggplant. So I've picked up all my produce here from Patty's Market. For my eggplant dish, I'm going to need some beautiful fresh mint and some eggplants. Lovely. Off to the kitchen. And this is a lovely dish to have at a barbecue. It can be a side dish, or if you're vegetarian, it can be the main event. Very, very simple and very, very yum. I'm gonna barbecue some eggplant. If you're working with a barbecue, that's cool. If you're gonna work from inside, a griddle pan or a grill pan with the stripes across it is best. So I've just got a couple of eggplant that I'm gonna slice. I'm just going to lay it out and spray it liberally with cooking oil. The reason for that is if you're cooking on a barbecue, you can't oil the griddle plate or it'll catch fire. And if you're using a griddle plate with the high grid on it, the oil sinks to the bottom and the eggplant will stick to those rails. And a sprinkle of salt and pepper as well. And you want this to go into a really nice hot pan. It needs to sizzle when you put it down. And once you put it down, leave it alone. Don't move it around because you want those beautiful bar marks on the eggplant. So while that's grilling away, I'm going to make a dressing for this, which is just a beautiful minted lemon yogurt. We'll start with a generous amount of mint leaves. This is just your common mint. It's the old stuff my nan used to grow underneath her tap at her house. If the tap had a little drip, then the mint used to love it. And the smell of this common mint reminds me of being at her house as a little kid. So to chop up a pile of herbs like this, nice soft herbs like mint or basil or parsley, instead of running the knife back and forth through it, which really leaves you with a very green board and not a lot of flavour left in your herbs, this is a way to get around that. So if you roll it all up into a bundle as tightly as you can, and then you're just going to take your time and slice that finely. Make sure you've got a nice sharp knife always. It's a lot safer to have a sharp knife than a blunt one, actually. So there you've got all your nice finely chopped herbs. Your board hasn't turned green, so all that beautiful fresh mint flavour is still right there. Okay, I'm going to pop that in with some yoghurt. This is just natural unsweetened yoghurt, Greek style yoghurt I like to use. And a juice of a lemon. Give that a little mix. So I'm just going to set that aside for all the flavours to meld together. Then we just want one shallot or spring onion, depends on which state you come from. I'm going to slice that very finely. So I'll just slice it on a long diagonal because I think it looks pretty when you sprinkle it over the top. I'm going to get the seeds out of this pomegranate now. I've seen a lot of different methods for this. It can depend very heavily on whether or not the pomegranate's ripe. But my favourite method that I've ever seen involves cutting it in half and then whacking it. So before you start, give it a bit of a roll and that loosens up all the seeds inside for you. Gonna make it a bit easier. Cut it in half and then I'm gonna whack it. It's gonna look like there's been bloodshed, but don't be alarmed. Oh. Okay, so that's all lovely and soft. You're looking for it to be really flexible like this. And that way you know it's cooked all the way through. So now I've just got to put it all on a platter. Some of our beautiful mint dressing on that. And we're going to scatter it with our beautiful shallots. Some of these gorgeous pomegranate seeds that just look like little rubies. And a few little mint leaves on top. And there you have it. Thank you for joining me in the Patty's Kitchen. I've really enjoyed cooking with beautiful autumn produce. For this recipe, barbecued eggplant and minted yogurt, go to sydneymarkets.com.au. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram @sydneymarkets. See you next time.